Okay, so welcome to the Restorative Sound Bath. I'm Micki, and this is Christian, and we're in our home studio that we like to call the So Fine Studio. And so for this Restorative Sound Bath, you have the option to have a sound bath of just laying down on the ground or on a couch or chair, sitting in a chair, whatever would feel most relaxing. If you want to incorporate some restorative yoga, what I'll invite you to do is use some props. So I have blankets, you might have pillows at home, you might have blocks, and I'll just set some of these things aside. So I'm going to introduce the very first shape, and this is going to be Babbling Brook. So like I said, you can either just lay fully on your back, or you might take a blanket and make a small roll. This is going to be right for underneath your heart center. And then maybe you have a pillow for underneath your knees. So we'll just find a position that's comfortable. I'm going to scooch forward and bring my knees over the top of the bolster. I'm going to lean back so that that roll is right underneath your heart center. And then allow your arms to open out wide to the sides. And take some nice deep breaths. You might close down the eyes and maybe take a few sighs out through the mouth. Rest more fully into the earth. As you arrive, allow any of your thoughts to dissipate. Imagine that your awareness, your thoughts in your mind, you can just let them go. And imagine you're able to travel your awareness down into your heart. As you arrive there, imagine a glowing flame, maybe a candle. Messages from the outside world. Maybe in this moment, you want to listen at your heart space for a message from yourself. Today is the very first yama of the yamas and the niyamas. This one is called Ahimsa, and it means nonviolence. I have a short reading from the book The Yamas and the Niyamas by Deborah Adele. Ahimsa means nonviolence. nonviolence calls forth from us our most brilliant and best self. Our capacity to be nonviolent depends on our practice of courage, balance, love of self, and compassion for others. Stay right where you are if you're comfortable, but if you want to change shapes, I'm going to invite you to move whatever prop you have out from underneath your knees, maybe kicking it out with your feet. You can roll onto one side, press yourself up into a seat, and then we'll move the blanket off to the side. Could always use it to cover yourself if you're getting chilly. Really, this practice is about calming your nervous system. If you have blocks, you might stack the blocks maybe into a little stair step position. So I might use a block on the medium setting, one on the low setting, and then if you had a pillow or bolster, you can lay it on top of the blocks, remembering that all of these shapes are optional. So I'm going to lay the bolster so I create a little ramp. From here, I have my legs in kind of a deer shape with my hip right up against the bolster, and then you can bring your side down to rest, allowing your head to rest either with your gaze forward, or maybe you turn your gaze behind you, laying your opposite cheek. But that's quite an intense twist, so feel free to find either version or whatever twist is going to work best in your body. Allow yourself this moment in time to soften. Allowing your breath to massage any places of stuck energy, maybe around the spine. Breathe into those sensations. Yourself time to rest here. Feel free to make any adjustments that you need in order to make this comfortable and sustainable. That you have choices and agency. Aware of your breath, to latch on to little bits of busyness. Invite those thoughts to release with your breath. And then take a moment to come back into your heart space, sensing that intention once more. Non-violence. She says our ability to stay balanced and courageous has much to do with how we feel about ourselves. Lighthearted and forgiving with ourselves, others will feel the ease and joy of being with us. If we find laughter and delight in ourselves, others will be healed in our presence. Hands. You might rotate around so that your arms are behind you, your knees are out in front, and you can take some little windshield wipers with the knees. Maybe turning the gaze in the opposite direction. You can set up for the second side, bringing your opposite hip around, and then either turning your gaze past your shoulder for a deeper twist, bringing your torso to rest, or you can send your gaze out in front of your chest. Some nice deep breaths as you soften into this shape, relaxing all of your effort. Feel held and supported. The goal is to make this pose and this shape sustainable so that we can calm and relax our nervous systems. Allow your breath to massage you from the inside out. each step, I touch the earth lightly. Her no harm. And she in turn does me no harm. Ahimsa nonviolence asks us to step lightly, to do no harm. Honor the relationship we have with the earth, with each other, and with ourselves. Soften. Take another nice deep breath wherever you are. To unwind your twist, pressing into your hand for support. You can take a moment to lean back and windshield wiper the knees a little side to side. And then we'll continue to use this prop just as it is, this little ramp. And we can do from here a reclined butterfly. So you might bring your seat right up against the bolster. You can bring your feet to touch, and then you might either bring more blocks if you have it, but I only have those two handy, so I'm going to use the blanket instead. I'm going to take the blanket and make a really big roll. And then we can place the roll on top of your feet and tuck the ends of the roll underneath your knees. And then allow yourself this moment in time to lean back. Maybe you can have another blanket that you want to roll up for underneath the head to create a little bit more of a pillow. Arms to drape at your sides, softening through your chest, allowing your heart to open, coming into a reclined butterfly, Supta Baddha Konasana. Close down the eyes if you like. Allow the shoulders to melt heavy. You can either rest your arms at your sides, or maybe you would like to rest your hands on your belly, feeling the rise and the fall of your breath. save people or fix them. All we can do is model. And that points the finger back to us. To fix or save in another. There is only the gift of listening. Stay longer in your reclined butterfly. But as soon as you'd like, you can press yourself up into a seat. And you might roll the props off to the side. And you can make your way onto your back. Come flat on your back. You might walk your feet out as wide as the mat. Allow the knees to cave in towards each other into a little teepee of support. You could rest your hands here on your belly or rest them at your sides. Take some nice deep long breaths. As you feel into the back body, pressing against the earth with every inhale, imagine almost like a gentle massage along the back. Massage. If you have this at home, or maybe you can round one up at a later date, if you have a tennis ball, we can actually use the tennis ball to give ourselves a little back massage. So imagining the tennis ball there as you inhale, or if you have one, you can bring it and we'll place it in between the shoulder blade and the spine. So you can come onto your back, roll over to one side, bring the tennis ball behind you, and then lay it in between your shoulder blade and your spine, maybe just finding gentle pressure. You might press your feet onto the mat here, and then maybe press into your feet and allow yourself to glide up and down. finding a gentle massage. Either with or without the ball, this gliding motion can feel really nice. If you're doing this on one side, go ahead and roll over, reach back to remove the ball, come back onto your back. Notice the differences side to side. To the opposite hand. You can roll onto one side, bring the ball behind you, roll onto the ball so that it's in between the shoulder blade and the spine. You can find a little gentle pressure here. Maybe press into the feet to glide the body. You can do this with or without a tennis ball, maybe a racquetball. Nothing at all, just pressing into the feet, finding a little bit of gliding sensation. Whenever you're ready, you can roll back onto the opposite side, remove the ball, and then come onto your back. From here, we'll do a little twist. So with your feet on the mat, you can walk your feet in towards your sit bones, press into your heels to lift your hips, scooch them over to the left, and then allow your knees to fall over to the right. Maybe you open your arms out into a giant T, turning your gaze away from your knees. Twist. You can even bring your hand to your knee or your thigh. You might find any position for the opposite arm and then allow yourself to settle in. Maybe using a blanket to cover the body. Press into your feet to lift your hips a little, scooch your hips to the right, allow the knees to float over to the left, and find that delicious spinal twist. Maybe turning the gaze over, the right hand away from the knees. You could bring your hand to your thigh if you'd like, or just relax that hand. Breath down the curve in the spine. center. A time to get out any body butter, maybe give the neck and shoulders a little rub. I'm using the handcrafted PDX body butter by Sandra Rose, and maybe you want to use this to give your neck a little massage before you get ready for your final rest. While we come into, when we come into our final resting position, this will be a sound bath, so you can allow yourself to really enjoy the music and the vibration. So get yourself all cozied up with socks, blankets, pillows. You could choose any of those original positions that we did in class. If you'd like to try them again or try one for the rest of class, that's fine too. I would recommend if you're laying on your back, it could be nice for your low back to elevate the knees. So you might use the support of a pillow or bolster. Maybe you drape blanket over the body, finding a little bit of weight could be soothing for the nervous system. And then give yourself this opportunity to just allow yourself to sink into the earth as you come into your final rest. Holocaust victim. She says, ultimately, we have just one moral duty: to reclaim large areas of peace in ourselves. More and more peace. Reflect it towards others, and the more peace there is in us, the more peace there will also be in our troubled world. Allow your breath to deepen. From your heart. For all the parts that are you. And start to imagine your bubbles of gratitude flowing from the heart, reaching down into the fingers and into the toes. You can start to wiggle the fingers and toes, gently rotate the wrists and the ankles, and then take a long body stretch, reaching your arms and legs long. Moment to stretch from your fingertips to your toes, and then you can roll onto one side. Bring your head onto your upper arm. Just take a moment to rest there in a fetal position. nice deep breaths. And then begin to use the strength of your arms to press yourself up into a seat. Invite your hands to meet at your heart center. And then allow your head to gently bow towards your heart. It's such an honor and privilege to guide you through this practice. And thank you to our musician, Sound Man. And just let us know if you have any questions about class. I'll be right with you.